So next we'll move to microbes in production of biogas. Microbes in production of biogas. So, first of all, we should know what is biogas. So, it is a mixture of gases. So, this means methane jada hota hai, and this is produced by the microbial activity. That microbial activity ka matlab hai anaerobic breakdown of or anaerobic digestion of biomass with the help of methanogenic bacteria. Okay, so those biogas can be used as fuel. तो पहले हम जानेंगे कि biogas क्या है. It is a mixture of gases जिसमें कि ज्यादातर predominantly methane होता है. Other gas भी होती है लेकिन ज्यादातर इसमें मिथेन होता है. सो मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस, सो प्रीडोमिनेंटली मिथेन, और वी कैन कॉल इट एज मिथेन रिच फ्यूएल गैस, ऑल्सो कॉल एज दैट इज मिथेन रिच फ्यूएल गैस. सो दैट प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय activity of microbes. So which type of microbes or microbial activity? That is anaerobic breakdown or digestion of biomass with methanogenic bacteria produced by microbial activity. ये जो microbial activity है इसका मतलब क्या है, इसमें किस टाइप का microbial activity होता है, that is anaerobic breakdown or digestion of biomass, anaerobic digestion, that breakdown of biomass, anaerobic breakdown of biomass. Anaerobic breakdown of biomass in order to release the energy or the fuel gases. उस fuel gases में ज्यादातर जो mixture of gases होता है उसमें ज्यादातर methane की amount ज्यादा होती है. Okay, so all of you know that methane is an inflammable gas. So जो anaerobic digestion के द्वारा हुआ by methanogenic bacteria. So methanogenic जो bacteria है वो मिथेन प्रोडक्शन करता है, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया. और ये एनरोबिक बैक्टीरिया है, सो एनरोबिक प्रोसेस में ये मिथेन प्रोडक्शन करते हैं, सो दैट इज नोन एज एनरोबिक मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया. सो जिसमें बायोगैस में 50-70% मिथेन होता है और 30-40% कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड होती है और सम अमाउंट ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड एंड हाइड्रोजन होती है. 50% of the combustible energy present in the organic waste can be changed into methane gas. जो biogas में जो content है उसका 50% methane gas में convert होता है. So biogas में क्या क्या होता है, methane होता है. So predominantly methane, maximum amount का methane है. So जो methane है that is 50-70%. और इसमें इसमें CO2 भी है, मिथेन 50-70%, और इसमें कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड है जो कि 30-40% होता है, एंड ट्रेसेस ऑफ नाइट्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड एंड हाइड्रोजन. सो नाइट्रोजन, हाइड्रोजन सल्फाइड एंड हाइड्रोजन, उसका स्मॉल अमाउंट होता है, स्मॉल अमाउंट होता है. और जो कंबस्टिबल एनर्जी है यदि प्रेजेंट इन द ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट, उसका 50% चेंज होता है मीथेन में, मीथेन गैस. सो 50% ऑफ कंबस्टिबल एनर्जी, सो 50% ऑफ कंबस्टिबल एनर्जी ऑफ 50% ऑफ कंबस्टिबल एनर्जी ऑफ ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट कैन बी चेंज इनटू मीथेन गैस. Can be changed into methane gas. 50% of the convertible energy. 50% energy convert हो सकता है. तो calorific value क्या है? So कुछ ना कुछ biogas का calorific value है. So certain bacteria which grow anaerobically on cellulose material produce large amount of methane. These bacteria collectively called as methanogens. Common and the common bacteria is methanobacterium. So cellulose material के ऊपर ज्यादातर grow करता है. तो cellulose जो rich amount of energy is there, तो cellulose के ऊपर grow होता है anaerobically. Certain bacteria तो एनरोबिकली सेलुलोज मेटेरियल के ऊपर ग्रो करते हैं, दैट प्रोड्यूस लार्ज अमाउंट ऑफ मीथेन. सो जो मीथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया जो है, मीथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया, उसका कॉमन एग्जाम्पल वो ग्रो को बोलते हैं मीथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया. उसका एक जेनस है मीथेनो बैक्टेरियम. तो मीथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया जो ग्रुप है उसका कुछ एग्जाम्पल्स है, जो एग्जाम्पल है मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम, ग्रो ऑन एनरोबिकली ऑन सेलुलोज मटेरियल. ये जो मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम है दैट ग्रो ऑन सेलुलोज मटेरियल एंड प्रोड्यूस हाई अमाउंट ऑफ high amount of methane, CH4, CO2 and high amount of biogas, hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen is a mixture of biogases. तो इसमें ज्यादातर एक्चुअली मिथेन होते हैं, CH4 होता है. और ये जो बैक्टीरिया है मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम और मिथेनोजेंस, मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम और मिथेनोजेंस, दैट इज कॉमनली फाउंड इन एनरोबिक स्लज ड्यूरिंग सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट. ये बैक्टीरिया जो हम मान लो एनरोबिक स्लज में होता है, जिसको एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में लिया गया, ये बैक्टीरिया उसमें होते हैं, क्योंकि वहां पर भी एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में भी बायोगैस रिलीज होती है. तो मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया इसका एग्जाम्पल है मिथेनोकोकस, और मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम और एक टाइप का भी है, मिथेनोकोकस भी हो सकता है, लेकिन ज्यादातर मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम होती है. So these bacteria present in commonly found in the anaerobic sludge ड्यूरिंग सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट. सो कॉमनली फाउंड इन एनारोबिक स्लॉज ड्यूरिंग सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट. तो आपको याद होगा कि ड्यूरिंग द सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट इन द एसटीपी सीवेज ट्रीटमेंट प्लांट जो सेकेंडरी ट्रीटमेंट होता है होने के बाद उसको जो सेटलिंग टैंक में ले आते हैं और नीचे जो सेटल डाउन हो जाती है दैट इज कॉल्ड एज एक्टिवेटेड स्लज. सो उसको जब लिया जाता है एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में, वो एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में ये बैक्टीरिया रहता है मेथनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया. सो दैट बैक्टीरिया कॉमनली फाउंड इन एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर. तो एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में वो एनरोबिकली एक्ट करता है और बायोगैस वहां पर भी रिलीज होती है. तो यहां पर भी बायोगैस रिलीज होता है, तो वहां पर एनरोबिक स्लज डाइजेस्टर में भी बायोगैस रिलीज होता है और यहां पर भी बायोगैस रिलीज होता है. प्रोसेस रिमेन सेम. And this bacteria also present the remain of the cattle. तो ये जो जिसके ऊपर एक्ट करता है ऑर्गेनिक वेस्ट के ऊपर, उसमें इसका अगर सेलुलोज ज्यादा होगा तो उसमें से अच्छे क्वांटिटी का बायोगैस निकलेगा. सो दिस ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट दिस बैक्टीरिया मिथनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया दैट इज ऑल्सो सम बैक्टीरिया सिम्बायोटिक बैक्टीरिया दैट इज प्रेजेंट इन साइड द स्टोमैक ऑफ कैटल. यू नो दैट कैटल स्टोमैक इज नोन एज कंपाउंड स्टोमैक रुमिनेटेड स्टोमैक. दैट्स व्हाई दोज आर नोन एज रुमिनेटेड एनिमल्स. तो उनके जो स्टोमैक में बहुत सारे चैम्बर्स है, उसमें चैम्बर है रुमेन. सो दिस बैक्टीरिया प्रेजेंट इन द रुमेन ऑफ द स्टोमैक ऑफ द कैटल्स एंड दिस बैक्टीरिया एनरोबिकली डाइजेस्ट द सेलुलोज. क्योंकि गाय तो खाता है पत्ते खाता है प्लांट्स खाता है तो उसमें तो सेलुलोज होता है, तो सेलुलोज को वो वहां पर डाइजेशन करता है एनरोबिकली. और काउ डंग में भी ये बैक्टीरिया भी निकलता है और पार्टली सेलुलोज भी निकलता है. ओके नेक्स्ट पॉइंट विल गो टू नेक्स्ट पॉइंट. सो दिस बैक्टीरिया ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट दिस बैक्टीरिया ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द ह्यूमन पार्ट ऑफ कैटल. दिस बैक्टीरिया ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इन द ह्यूमन. ह्यूमन इज द पार्ट ऑफ स्टोमैक. Rumen of cattle. Rumen of cattle. This bacteria help in the breakdown of cellulose. यहां पर कैसे बैठे करते हैं ये कॉज. ये बैक्टीरिया क्या करते हैं ब्रेकडाउन करते हैं, क्योंकि कैटल फूड में ज्यादातर much amount of cellulose is there in the cattle food. So this bacteria cause breakdown of cellulose in the rumen part of the stomach. So this play an important role in the nutrition of the cattle. Agar cellulose ko digestion nahi karega to cattle usko absorb nahi kar payega, to energy nahi milega. Breakdown of cellulose. So isliye मिथेनोजेनिक और तो मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया उसमें भी उसका भी नाम है रुमेनोकोकस. ये जो बैक्टीरिया है ऑलरेडी हैव स्टडीड इज नोन एज रुमेनोकोकस. ये भी एक मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया जैसे है मिथेनोबैक्टीरियम और एक भी मिथेनोकोकस है उस टाइप का इधर भी है रुमेनोकोकस. सो ये जो ब्रेकडाउन करता है सेलुलोज को प्ले एन इंपोर्टेंट रोल इन द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ कैटल. सो इंपोर्टेंट रोल इन द न्यूट्रिशन ऑफ द कैटल्स. सो द एस्ट्रेटा जो निकलता है डम दैट इज कॉल्ड द काउ डम दैट इज कॉमनली कॉल्ड एज अ गोबर दैट इज रिच इन दिस बैक्टीरिया सो दिस डम कैन बी यूज फॉर जनरेशन ऑफ बायोगैस कॉमनली कॉल्ड गोबर गैस क्योंकि काउ डम में बहुत सारे पार्टली ब्रेकडाउन हुआ सेलुलोज रहता है और बहुत सारे मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया रहता है इसलिए काउ डम को भी हम सोर्स ले सकते हैं एनर्जी सोर्स और काउ डम को भी बायोगैस प्रोडक्शन में काउ डम का इस्तेमाल होता है दैट्स व्हाई दैट बायोगैस इज नोन एज गोबर गैस सो दिस पॉइंट विल गो टू नेक्स्ट पॉइंट एस्क्रेटा ऑफ कैटल कॉमनली कॉल्ड एज काउ डम इसको हम बोलते हैं गोबर सो दिस एस्क्रेटा ऑफ काउ डम और गोबर रिच इन सेलुलोज एंड बैक्टीरिया सो रिच इन सेलुलोज एंड मिथेनोजेनिक बैक्टीरिया And used, so cow dungs are used, can be used for generation of biogas. So that's why that is called as gobar gas. Can be used for generation of biogas. So, commonly called as gobar gas. So how the biogas plant is actually operate? Okay. So there are many stages there. So the biogas generation is a three-stage anaerobic digestion of animal and organic waste. And the organic waste consists of lignin, cellulose, hemicellulose, lipids, proteins. These are the organic waste. So biogas contains those organic waste. So now go to the mechanism of the biogas production in the next video. We'll go to the mechanism of biogas production. So, biogas production plant is there. So, how the biogas is produced, in what steps these are produced, there are three stages of the biogas production. We'll discuss in the next video. So in continuation with microbes used for production of biogas, now we move to the steps involved in the biogas production. So
steps in biogas production. So three main steps are there in the biogas production, and those are known as solubilization, next is acidogenesis, then is methanogenesis. So three main steps involved in the biogas production. So number one is solubilization, number two is acidogenesis, and number three is methanogenesis. So three main steps out of this three main steps out of these three main steps, first of all, the different organic wastes or organic matter is first broken down into the soluble form. That is known as the solubilization. So what are the organic matter that is involved here? The organic matter that is involved in the solubilization, so different kinds of organic matter is there. That is cellulose, then is the hemicellulose, storage polysaccharides. So different kinds of organic matters are here. So we have to write it in a schematic form. That is first step we are going to show you. That is solubilization, then is hemicellulose, acicellulose, next is hemicellulose, next is storage polysaccharides, fats and proteins. So they are converted to the monomers. So they are broken down into different kinds of monomeric units. So all the complex organic compounds first is broken down to simpler forms, and that is known as solubilization. So this step includes solubilization. So cellulose is broken down to cellulose and hemicellulose, broken down to glucose, and the polysaccharides that is broken down to also its monosaccharides. Fats is broken down to glycerol and fatty acid. Proteins are broken down to amino acids. So that is by decomposer microbes. So this step is conducted by decomposer microbes. After the solubilization process is over, next the monomeric units, they are converted to organic acids. So that step is known as acidogenesis. And the most common is the acetic acid. So that is converted to organic acids. The different kinds of organic acids are produced, but the most common is acetic acid. Okay. So this step is known as acidogenesis. So in the acidogenesis process, it involves the fermentation causing microbes. So that is by fermentative microbes. By fermentative microbes. So first of all, the solubilization, then is the formation of organic acids, that is known as acidogenesis. After that, the organic acid is converted to biogas, that is known as the methanogenesis. Organic acids converted to biogas. So various kinds of mixture of gases are produced in the biogas. You know that the main amount is methane. So other gases are also there. So CH4, CO2, H2S, nitrogen, hydrogen. So these are the gases produced, that is known as the collectively called as the biogas. And this step is conducted by methanogenic bacteria, and this process is known as methanogenesis. That process is known as methanogenesis. And this step, methanogenesis, is conducted by methanogens. The methanogenic bacteria are known as methanogens. So these are the three steps in the production of the biogas. So how is a biogas plant? How it looks, the biogas plant? There are, that is having the digester, the floating roof, or the known as the gas holder. So different types of instruments are used for the biogas plant. So it is having a digester to which the all these organic substances are loaded. That is known as the digester. Concrete chamber, it is known as the digester, and upon that which, upon the concrete chamber, there is a gas holder. So it floats in the gas holder. So as you look at the biogas plant, there are different parts of the biogas plant. So you can refer the insert a book, there the diagram has been given. You can also report that diagram. So, and in the biogas production, you can mark here the slurry. The slurry means the cow dung along with water that is fed to the digester. And upon the digester, there is a floating gas holder. So if you look at the diagram of the biogas plant, biogas plant. So it is a large concrete tube. The biogas plant consists of a concrete tube 10 to 15 feet deep, in which bio waste are collected and slurry of dung is fed. So now look here. So it is a concrete tube 10 to feet. It is a concrete tube or a concrete box like structure.
So this concrete tank is 10 to 15 feet deep. So you can also follow the page number 186 of the NCRT. So upon which a holder is placed. Is flowed over the tube. And this holder has an outlet where the gases are released. The biogases are released through this holder. So the digester is fed by dog water. So there is a feeding chamber here. This is the feeding chamber. The dog water is placed over here. The dog water is put in this chamber and the sludge is released from here. There is another outlet, so that is having the sludge. So the dog water is put here, this is called as the slurry. This one is known as the digester. This, and this one is the floating, that float in the slurry, that is floating gas holder. And the dump water is put over here in this chamber. So the dog water is put in the chamber that will be fed to digester. And the sludge is also put here, sludge. And as this digester have the anaerobic methane gels, so when the anaerobic methane gels act upon the slurry or the dog water or in which the cellulose are present, then there is the release of the methane and carbon dioxide. All types of gases are released here. Methane plus carbon dioxide plus other gases. And those gases release from here and they will go to the outlet. Outlet of the floating gas holder. Now this gas is released through the floating gas holder and this gas is stored at a gas container which can be later used for the fuel purpose. Now you can do this diagram. This is a typical biogas plant where all the parts are put in the right places. So you can also right here, it's a biogas plant. A typical biogas plant. So after this, we can explain this. So how the biogas plant works and what is the components of the biogas plant.
the biogas plant consists of a tank that is known as the concrete tank, 10 to 15 feet deep, in which the biogas plant consists of a concrete tank 10 to 12 feet deep in which biowaste are collected. And the dung water that called slurry of dung is fed. The dung water is known as the slurry. So, slurry of dung is fed. A floating gas holder is placed over the slurry. Or floating gas holder. A floating gas holder is placed over the slurry. So as the gas releases, this floating gas holder or the cover that will rise up, then it will rise up and down as the gas forms, and also the formation do not take place. At the time of formation, when the gas releases, it will move up. When the gas is not released, it will come back to its original position, original floating position. Gas holder keeps on rising as the gas is produced in the tank, because inside this digester, this is a tank, here the activity of microbes is going on. That's why the gas are produced, the biogas are produced. So due to the microbial activity inside the tank, the gas is produced, and as the gas produced, the gas holder keeps on rising. This floating gas holder keeps on rising. Floating gas holder keeps on rising as the gas is produced in the tank. By microbial activity. This biogas plant has an outlet which is connected to a pipe, and that pipe to supply the biogas to nearby houses, and the spent slurry is removed through another outlet. So here the sludge is removed, the spent slurry which has already been, activity has already been completed. This is called spent sludge or spent slurry. So that is removed, and that can be applied in the agricultural fields. So
The biogas plant has an outlet.
Biogas plant has an outlet.
Which is connected to a pipe to supply.
Suppose here you can look here. This is the outlet. Suppose this is outlet. और इसके अंदर गैस जा रहा है तो यहां पर एक पाइप हम इस कनेक्टर के द्वारा एक पाइप हम जोड़ देंगे. दिस इज द अदर पाइप. यहां पर आउटलेट खत्म हो गया. इस कनेक्टर के थ्रू में हम पाइप को जोड़ दी. इसमें गैस सप्लाई होके नियर बाय हाउस इसको सप्लाई हुआ या फिर पाइप पर स्टोरेज हुआ. सो द बायोगैस प्लांट हैज एन आउटलेट व्हिच इज कनेक्टेड टू ए पाइप टू सप्लाई बायोगैस टू नियर बाय हाउसेस. आउटलेट कनेक्टेड टू पाइप टू सप्लाई बायोगैस to nearby houses. And इसमें spent slurry, a spent slurry is collected over here, and that is after removing from here, that can be used in as the compost or applied in the field, agricultural field. The spent slurry, a spent sludge, spent slurry, you can call it as spent sludge. So that spent slurry or spent sludge is removed through another outlet. Is removed through another outlet. And used as fertilizer. So though the biogas which is produced, that is used for cooking purpose, because in the rural belt the biogas plant is established at the rural site, so that biogas is produced used for cooking and the lighting purpose. Biogas plant mostly established at rural areas, because in the rural areas the availability of the cow dung is higher, because the main slurry or the main organic waste that is required, that is the cow dung, large quantity of cattle dumps available in the rural areas. So biogas plants are more often built in rural areas due to higher availability of cow dumps. The technology of the biogas production was developed in India mainly due to the efforts of Indian Agricultural Research Institute IARI and KVIC. This technology was established, the technology of biogas production developed in India. It's a very important point, important information. You should remember the name of two organizations that developed the technology of the biogas plant. So, technology of biogas production was a very important point, informational point. Technology for biogas production was developed in India by Indian Agricultural Research Institute IARI, Indian Agricultural Research Institute, shortly called IARI, and Khadi and Village Industries Commission. Khadi and Village Industries Commission. So known as KVIC. So IARI and KVIC first developed the technology for biogas production in India. So what is the calorific value? How we can count the calorific value of the biogas? So it is of the different type of values are there. So I already told you about the percentage of the different gases in the biogas. Already know that methane 50 to 70% is highly inflammable, CO2 30 to 40%, and mixture of other gases are 10%, like the hydrogen sulfide, H2, like that. So calorific value of biogas is 4429 kilocalorie per meter square at 50% methane content. This is very important information. So you should remember that information, calorific value of biogas. Calorific value of biogas is 4429 kilocalorie per meter square. 4429 kilocalorie per meter square. So this amount of energy will be produced per meter square area of the biogas when its content is 50% methane. So at 50% CH4 content. At 50% CH4 content. So with this, this part of the biogas production is completed. So next we will go to the microbes used as biocontrol agents. So first of all, we should know what is biocontrol or biological control. So in order to protect the crops agricultural crops and the vegetables from the harmful pathogenic microbes and insects. So some measure has to be taken place which involve the biological activity of other organisms. So to control the pathogens and the insects, certain kinds of insecticides, herbicides are applied, but those are the chemical substances that can cause the pollution in nature and also decrease the food value or nutrition value of the food products. So in order to avoid the chemical substances which act as the disease control or for insecticides, pesticides, so in order to avoid the chemical substances, certain biological activity or biological measure has been developed or initiated which use the living organisms to control the pests, that is insects and disease causing organisms. So that method is known as biologically controlling of pests and diseases, or shortly called as biocontrol agents. So now we'll study how the microbes are helpful in the as the biocontrol agent. So microbes as, so we'll give some certain examples, that is microbes used as biocontrol agents. So what are the microbes that is used as biocontrol agents?